All right, as you can see, tonight we have our friends here from the Seneca Park Zoo, and we have Tim and Ernie.
Hi, guys. How's it going?
It's dinner time. Ernie's having a little snack.
Oh, yeah.
Tell us about Ernie.
Ernie is a domestic mallard, sometimes called a Rhone duck, after a city in France. And as a domestic mallard, or a domestic duck, they've actually been bred over time to be more helpful to people. He's actually been bred as a food duck, so over time, people had him develop a bigger body. Oh, we're going to stay on this side.
Mm-hmm.
A bigger body, and actually the females will lay larger eggs.
Oh, and now this is a male, and we could tell by its coloring, and that's kind of interesting. The males are much more colorful than the
that
females.
That is exactly correct, yeah. So the males have those bright green heads, and those help them to advertise that they're big, strong, and healthy. Mm-hmm. The females will usually have, the females will usually have more muted colors that are better camouflage because they actually will have to hide on their nests to keep the ducklings safe.
Very cool. All right, and now we see that he's not able to fly very well, and you talked about them being bred up, and you know this is true of domestic breeds that they have lost that ability because they've gotten so big and bulky, right?
That's true of many of them, yeah.
Yep.
So over time, because they developed larger bodies, a lot of times they weren't necessarily bred to have larger wings. Now that's really helpful for a farm duck because you wouldn't want all of your food ducks to fly away.
Right. And that's why they wanted a larger body. This guy was bred to be a food duck.
That is exactly
correct.
Luckily
for him, he ended up at the zoo. Oh, hey.
He helped
plus
himself.
Plus
one foot. Hit the jackpot there, yep.
Yeah. All right. And I noticed he's got the band on his leg.
Good
that's
observation.
Not, yep.
Yep. So he has a band so he can help identify. Many ducks can oftentimes look very, very similar. So if something were to happen where one might not be feeling well or might need some medicine or some special food, it's important to make sure the right one gets the right medication.
Very
if you
good.
Actually visit our zoo, you notice that a lot of our penguins will have different bands so we can distinguish from individuals.
I've seen when they feed them, and they keep track of who gets what.
Exactly correct. Yep.
And now that's important. Different than the band that we would see on the pet species, which has to be put on when they're young, right?
Correct. Yep.
Yep. Yep.
Now, do ducks migrate south, or do they stay around here? What do they do?
Good question. So wild mallards, or the mallards you might typically find not on farms, will oftentimes migrate. Now, you will still see some around this area. So the fellows who live here during the summertime will migrate south where there's more food and warmer weather. But the ones even further north in Canada will oftentimes migrate down to this area, because now that all of our mallards have left, there's a lot more space and resources for them here.
Yeah. Well, he's enjoying
He's enjoying,
his
yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. Now, let's talk about he obviously doesn't fly well, but he still could swim very well, right?
Oh, he's a fantastic swimmer, yep. So you'll see he's got these fantastic web feet, and those help him to paddle through the water. And in fact, he can control how much blood his feet are getting, so he can paddle through in cold water as well, making sure he doesn't get too cold.
Right, and they actually have concurrent blood vessels to. You want to talk a little about that? Because that's really kind of cool when you think you see these guys in the winter. Why aren't their legs freezing?
Yep.
They've got no feathers or protection on them.
Yeah, so by restricting the blood, so making it so that only a little blood, just enough so that their feet are still getting some nutrients, he can help to make sure that his blood doesn't get too cold too quickly, or his feet don't get too cold too quickly, and that might help to cool all of him off if it did happen.
Very cool. And the other thing is the veins and arteries are kind of wrapped around each other, so as the cold blood's going back up, the warmer blood that's coming down transfers a lot of its heat over, and you know that's not lost every time.
That's a very good point.
So,
yeah,
you know,
so
they
hit
very
a
cool.
medium
that's,
temperature between the two.
Yeah.
Where do ducks live around here, as far as like other than your zoo, obviously?
Oh, sure. Well, you can find them anywhere there's a fair amount of water nearby, especially slow-moving or still water. So ponds, lakes, streams, marshes, swamps, bogs occasionally. in fact, there's a large population that might find nearby in places like Birch and Swamp.
Oh, very cool.
All right.
And we see he's getting mealworms.
Oh, yeah, good observation.
Yep.
Yeah, one of his very favorite treats. See if I can bring him around front here.
Okay.
That didn't last long. tiny little beetle larva called mealworms that he very much enjoys.
Very cool.
Oh, wow.
Well, thank you. Well, thanks for bringing Ernie on. I see Ernie left us a present on our desk.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks a lot, Ernie.
Thank you, Ernie.